The Missouri River has played a major role in our history. Some modern-day sailors decided to retrace a part of Lewis and Clark's journey up the Big Muddy. While the river has changed considerably since those early explorers' times, the spirit of adventure remains undiminished.
Retracing part of Lewis and Clark's adventure was just part of the Legion's plan for cruising from pier to Mobridge.
Well, I think one of the things that we wanted to do was to emphasize the role that the Missouri River played in the development of both North and South Dakota. As you know, this then ended up as a bicentennial project with the North Dakota Department of the American Legion also endorsing it as their centennial project.
And we were to sit down and develop the idea of something that would bring South Dakota together in a central area that would help everybody in the state to, so that they could take a part and to help South Dakota have a happy birthday.
South Dakota Game, Fish, and Parks Department. The flotilla put in at Pike Haven for fuel, snacks, and a chance to regroup.
How's it going so far?
Well, I think it's going pretty well. It's a little rough today, and you know, the boats are getting bounced around pretty good, but we made it here in good time, and we're pretty much on schedule.
Okay, and how many boats did we have when we took off there?
Well, I think we counted around 43 or so. Jim Larson had a count a little bit ago and had 43 as we were about halfway up here, so around 43.
How fast are we going?
About 25 miles an hour. You know, a lot of us that are using the reservoir system today are young enough that we don't remember the old Missouri. And, you know, my kids, for example, feel like the river came this way. They don't realize this is a big reservoir that was created by man. And I think that legacy of the old muddy Missouri is something that we need to keep in mind. And, you know, if this trip calls attention to that or reminds us of that way, I guess that's a good thing.
After re-energizing, it was time to head on toward Whitlock's Crossing near Gettysburg.
Come on.
were guests of the Gettysburg Post of the American Legion and visited there to hear some thoughts about South Dakota's centennial.
The centennial as a whole has generated more enthusiasm than I suspected it would. In our area, we had our 100th anniversary in 1983, and that was a big event for a little town, and we kind of figured that this probably wouldn't be so important. We had more people back for our school reunion than that than I think we did in 83. It was just amazing. The state's done a good job of getting the word out and getting the people enthused. I think it's been a good event. It's been a good year for South Dakota.
Then it was back on board the Teton for the final leg of our voyage. As predicted, the flotilla slowed only a little and made landfall at Mobridge about 4:30.
How's this kind of river trip different from 100 years ago river trip?
Well, I suspect, first of all, it's faster and a whole lot more comfortable. I don't know how fast they traveled upstream 100 years ago with the steamships and the flatboats, but I suspect it was single-digit miles an hour, 3-4 miles an hour, as opposed to the 25 mile an hour which we just made going into the wind. So certainly it was more enjoyable. We also knew where we were going, and 100 years or more ago, they were coming up this river and didn't know where they were going. And we're delighted that our friends from North Dakota came down and participated with us in this. We have about 4 or 5 projects we're working jointly on with North and South Dakota, since it's also their centennial. And it's just been a delightful experience, something we've talked about doing many times, going from Pier to Mobridge by boat, and we've not done it. So now we have, and it was fun, and I think perhaps we'll do it again.
Capping the day was a buffalo barbecue put on by the Mobridge Ambassadors Club and an American Legion get-together.
We have a 3-part focus at the Centennial in South Dakota. The celebration, which is recognizing the state's birthday. The heritage, which is recognizing where we've come, looking at where we've been these past 100 plus years. And thirdly, a lasting legacy aspect. This is part of the celebration, perhaps part of the heritage. One of the neat things about these 300 plus communities that are official centennial communities, each one of them agreed to do those three things: have a celebration, leave a legacy, and study the heritage. One of the neat things is that many of them have done first time community celebrations, and they tell us they're going to continue to do it, that it's been very enjoyable, they've had a good time, they've brought a lot of people home, and found out that it didn't take an awful lot of work to do it. So yes, I think we'll see a lot of these things happen again. There was talk on the boat before we even got here that let's do it again next year. So I think this will be one of the many things that will be continued on into the future.